Hi, my name is Elena with Manatee County Parks and Natural Resources. Welcome to Explorers Academy. Today we're going to learn about a very special diverse group of animals called mollusks. Mollusks can be anything from a slug or an octopus or a squid or even a clam or a mussel. Today we're going to learn about what makes them so special and unique and how we can help them out in the wild. Most mollusks fall under three different classes: cephalopods, gastropods, and bivalves. If you have visited the beach, you have likely come in contact with a mollusk. All the beautiful seashells you see washed up on the shore were once living mollusks. All mollusks have a special layer of tissue called the mantle. In many mollusks, this structure is responsible for secreting calcium carbonate to create the shell. These shells act as exoskeletons, helping to protect the animal's soft body. The two classes of mollusks that most commonly create shells are gastropods and bivalves. Gastropods are a group of animals made up of over 65,000 species of snails and slugs. This diverse class can be found in a large variety of habitats, both land and sea, from gardens to mountains to deserts to estuaries, even in the deep of the ocean on hydrothermal vents. Many gastropod species have an intricate spiral shell. On Manatee County beaches, some commonly seen gastropod shells include lightning whelks, Florida conchs, tulip snails, and crown conchs. In addition to their shells, these snails have an extra protection called an operculum. Located on the bottom of the foot, this structure acts as a small door, helping to protect the snail from drying out or, in some cases, from predators. The class of mollusks called bivalves get their name from the two hinged parts that make up their shell. This group includes clams, mussels, oysters, and scallops. They live in both saltwater and freshwater. Most bivalves are filter feeders, using their gills to capture small particles of food floating in the water. This filter feeding also helps to clean the water, removing contaminants and algae. In addition to their water cleaning superpower, bivalves, like oysters, build reefs, helping to reduce erosion by creating a buffer between the shore and the waves. The class cephalopod includes squid, octopus, and cuttlefish. Most species in this class have no shell and are often characterized by their prominent head and set of arms or tentacles. Many cephalopods have color-changing capabilities to blend into their environment. They have tiny cells called chromatophores, which allow them to alter the color of their bodies to camouflage. They also use these color-changing abilities to warn predators or signal to their mate by flashing colors in specific patterns. Mollusks can provide many benefits to our economy, wildlife, and our coastline. Oysters, clams, squid, mussels, and many other mollusks are not only main contributors to the seafood industry, but also provide food for wildlife like birds, fish, and dolphins. Oyster beds stabilize our coastline and clean our waters, while lightning whelks can provide homes for animals like hermit crabs and barnacles. To say thank you to mollusks for all that they do, you can help by cleaning up your local beaches, following the laws for harvesting mollusks and their shells, and use less pesticide and chemicals that would end up in our waterways. Thank you for joining us for Explorers Academy. We hope you enjoyed learning all about mollusks and their amazing abilities. Please join us next time and look for our videos on YouTube and Facebook. Look for Manatee County Parks and Natural Resources. See you next time. Bye-bye.